Hey guys, good morning. Welcome to another brand new week. I'm Livvy Tower, bringing you a dose of love and light to bless you through the week. My topic today is a bit of a sensitive one due to personal reasons. Still, I thought I had to deal with and face head on, and I hope somebody out there picks something off this vlog that will encourage them or help them to deal and or overcome whatever it is that they're going through related to this particular issue. I spent a good part of yesterday scrolling through Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram messages and tributes and dedications to the amazing fathers out there putting in work. And oh, I thought it was amazing. Like, shout out to all the good fathers out there putting in work. And I'd like to send a special shout out to all the fathers out there who are playing a part in their children's lives. You fulfilling your role as a teacher, a provider, a protector, a companion is the highest, holiest service to mankind. A good father makes all the difference in a child's life. He is the pillar of strength and support and discipline. His work is endless and oftentimes thankless. There's an old saying that goes, any man can be a daddy, but it takes a special man to be a father. Special shout out goes to the uncles, grandpas, stepdads, and men that are raising somebody else's kids. It takes a special man to do that. Y'all are the real MVP. To all the figures that stepped in the absence of the father, whether it be cousins or brothers, I salute you. Here's to the potential fathers as well, fathers to be, our lost fathers watching us from heaven, and to our almighty father up in his kingdom. Happy Father's Day. To the men out there trying to be better fathers, your children need you. The relationship with the opposite sex parent has the profoundest of bearings on whether or not we will grow up to be happy, serene, healthy, fulfilled individuals. The way in which a father interacts with his daughter growing up is a major factor in how a woman's nervous system is wired, which in turn impacts her physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual health, her self-image, her view of the world, and the ease or otherwise with which she loves and trusts as a woman. It is a fact that positive fathering produces well-adjusted, confident, and successful daughters who relate well to the men in their lives. The first man every female bonds with is her father, and that imparts on her so strongly that any later relationships with men, including romantic ones, are filtered through that experience. Daughters need to know that the first man in their lives loved them unconditionally, as all her relationships with men will be patterned after that first love. To all the girls growing up without their fathers, I'd just like to say, before you took your first breath, God knew who you were. God knew who you would be. Key into God to deal with whatever demons it is that you're dealing with. Ask God to give you supernatural grace that surpasses all human understanding to deal with any feelings of fear or hatred or loneliness, even self-esteem issues. If your father is alive, pray to God to touch his heart and to make him realize his role in your life. Pray to God that he may heal your heart so that you don't have to work with any feelings of resentment. You cannot forgive if you are not healed inside. To all the angry mothers out there, make peace. Just because a man is terrible at a relationship doesn't mean he's terrible at being a father. Don't take that away from him because he didn't love you right. You're only taking away from your child. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this encourages and blesses somebody out there today. It is the only reason I am doing this. If you would like to see me do more videos, please write a comment on the comment box below and subscribe to my channel. That would be awesome. I'd love to have more subscribers just to know that there's an audience out there watching. If you're blessed, I am blessed, and we're all blessed. God bless you and have a lovely week. I know I'm praying for much too much, but could you send back the only man she loved? I know you don't do it usually, but dear Lord, she's
night I fall asleep, and this is all I ever dream.